This video demonstrates the angle of minimum deviation of laser light passing through a prism. So what I have set up here is I've got a beam of laser light, and you can see the path that it would take if there was no prism in the way. When I do put the prism in the way, however, you see that the laser light that was passing over the top of the prism still comes over here, but the piece that actually passed through the glass ends up being diffracted way over here. So the angle between where the light would have gone and where it is going now, having passed through that prism, is called the angle of deviation. One thing that's interesting is that the amount that the light gets deviated over here changes depending on what angle the light is hitting this prism face at. So by changing the position of the prism, we can make this angle of deviation bigger or smaller. So I'm going to do this now. I've got this prism mounted on a rotating platter, and I'm going to move this back and forth and show you what happens to that angle of deviation. So if I turn the prism in this direction, you're going to see that spot of light get farther away. In other words, the angle that the light is deviated by will get larger. So let me demonstrate. I turn it this way, and that spot gets farther away. If I turn it back the other way, you're going to see something interesting. It comes closer, and then it turns around and starts heading out again. So there is a minimum angle of deviation, that point where the spot of light changes direction. And if you go too far in either direction, that beam of light gets farther away rather than closer. So that angle is called the angle of minimum deviation, because the angle between where the light was supposed to go and where it did go is at its minimum. So let's have a look at this from above. So here you can see my prism, and I am going to move my light source so that you can see the beams a little bit better. So now you can see the beam going into the prism, through the prism, and also exiting the prism. Now if I move this back and forth a little bit, you can see what the beam inside the prism is doing. The angle of minimum deviation takes place here, and you might notice that things look pretty symmetric in this situation. The beam inside the prism is going straight across, parallel to this far face. If I turn the prism in one direction, it's no longer parallel. If I turn it in the other direction, it's again no longer parallel. And the angle of minimum deviation takes place when it is parallel. In other words, when the beam inside the glass is at 90 degrees relative to the plane between the two faces.